Hey everyone, I'm Zoe Hewitt and welcome to another episode of Nonprofit Party. Now today's episode is a party in the sky as we talk to one of the volunteer pilots for Angel Flight. This awesome organization has received 4 stars on Charity Navigator.
Since 1983, pilots have been donating their time. Can you tell us a little bit about how the organization works?
We have about 1,300 pilots. We cover the 13 western states, including Alaska and Hawaii. There are other Angel Flight organizations elsewhere in the country, but people with mostly medical needs, but other pressing needs where air transportation makes the difference.
And what's really cool is that Angel Flight actually has a 4-star rating on Charity Navigator. So that's the best of best.
Yeah, the service delivery is all provided free of charge. There's no charge of any kind to the passengers. And the 100% of the cost of the airplanes, the flights, the fuel is borne by the pilots. Beyond that, it's people to keep the lights on and get things scheduled.
So how many flights does Angel Flight fly? That's like a tongue twister.
How many flights does Angel Flight fly? I think it was somewhere around 3,000 last year, Angel Flight West.
How is it that people sign up?
We work through doctors and social workers primarily. The Angel Flight will do a quick qualification of them and then get them in our system. From there, I'll just use a social worker example. Whose social worker will call and who's aware of the child's schedule in terms of treatments and doctors and places they have to go. Say that we need a person picked up in the city, brought to Santa Monica for a certain treatment, and then flown home. Angel Flight then goes into an incredible dispatch facility. It's like scheduling an airline where you have all these people and all these airplanes and everything else, and they basically publish to the pilot community the list of available missions, as they're called. Once those are posted, then the pilots can log on, see what missions are available, and then submit ourselves and our aircraft particular mission. On the mission list is how many passengers we're going to carry, how much they weigh, which is a very important consideration in small planes, how far we're going, what the fuel requirements are going to be, and a little bit about what the challenges are facing the patient. And so from those, you pick, you know, a mission that fits my profile, one that I'm comfortable flying, and one that my airplane is can do.
Also very important.
And then what my schedule is. Uh-huh. And so all those things have to line up. And then you request that mission. So for every mission out there, it gets scheduled, you know, 2, 3, 4 times before it's actually flown. Patient schedules change. Pilot schedules change. The airplane maybe have to go in for maintenance, unforeseen maintenance, and things like that. So the airplane's not available. And then the other thing that just throws a total wrench in the system is weather. So those people in the office do an amazing job.
It sounds like they are just coordinating and coordinating, right. Like a never-ending job,
right.
It sounds
right.
Like.
And then on the longer flights, because many of our small planes aren't capable of flying great distances, and we cover a radius of about 1,000 miles, but a lot of people can't go that far. So on the longer flights, what they'll do is they'll set up legs, mission legs. And so where if somebody's in Idaho and they need to come to L.A., we'll do that. If they're going to need a pilot to fly in from Idaho about as far as they can go, and then I will fly out to that place and meet that pilot with that passenger, pick them up, and bring them back. And so when you start getting into multiple legs, as you can see, this gets
right.
Exponentially more difficult.
More and more people to coordinate.
Right, right, right.
And this is not something that's just available to anyone who says, I don't feel like flying commercial. You have to prove need.
That need screening is done, you know, by the Angel Flight office through the social workers and the doctors and whatnot. Now, aside from that, we also fly to specialized summer camps for kids with special needs, burn camps. Little knowns will fly parents that are going to go meet a child that they're considering to adopt. The funnel is wide in terms of the things we'll do.
Do you see the same people again and again as they continue treatment?
Oh, we have our regulars, certainly. Certainly, and they have their favorite pilots.
Of course, don't we?
And their favorite airplanes. I learn a lot about other people's airplanes. Actually flying a woman back to Sacramento one time, and then we go by the call sign Angel Flight. And so I was like, this is Angel Flight 5 Kilo Tango, 10 miles out. I got the information, you know, basically requesting my landing clearance. And after we landed and we're rolling out, the tower controller said, hey, Helen, welcome back. So even the tower people and air traffic control know the passengers.
That's so nice. I mean, it is really, it's like a community in the sky.
Here's an example of one of my recent passengers. She has been battling a particularly nasty form of cancer for 9 years. Every time she gets a clean bill of health or goes into remission, it comes back. She was telling me that before Angel Flight, she would go in for her chemo, get in her car and drive as far as she could before she got sick. So she would end up somewhere around Bakersfield, and she would go into a hotel and be sick for 1, 2, 3 days before she felt well enough to get in her car and finish her drive home. We took off out of Santa Monica, and we were flying her home, and we happened to be flying over Bakersfield. Mm-hmm. Leaned over to give her a nudge and point out Bakersfield to her. Say, aren't you glad you weren't there? And I looked over there, and she was sound asleep. And I thought, wow, what an amazing thing we're doing for these people. I give back, you know, through aviation, through Angel Flight. I've flown relief efforts into Haiti after the earthquake. And I'm involved with Veterans Airlift Command that provides air service to military veterans. The vast majority of pilots that I know do this, at least have one of these organizations that they support.
The average person doesn't get to fly in a small aircraft. That's right. Really unusual and, you know, a really special treat, but mm-hmm. It's also scary. There's a lot more turbulence. Right, you're flying with, you know, not a big name like mm-hmm. American Airlines.
Right.
You're flying with a private person. So mm-hmm. Do you see a lot of people who get nervous? I mean, they have bigger things to worry about, but who get in and go, I don't know about
this. We are the least of their worries in terms of what it is they're facing that day. Angel Flight has a fabulous, fabulous safety record, and that's achieved through the pilots that we choose. The requirements are pretty stiff, you know, to become a pilot.
Everyone who volunteers with the organization doesn't actually have to have a pilot's license. So if you don't fly, you can still volunteer with Angel Flight. What other categories are needed?
If you love airplanes and you love to go flying but you don't have a license, I would recommend being what we call a mission assistant. And on certain flights, especially carrying children and things like that, you can ride along mm-hmm. as a mission assistant. With that, you sometimes it's translation. Sometimes it's just tending to kids, and sometimes it's just for a ride-along. You can also volunteer your time to the office.
If anyone out there would like to nominate someone to be a patient on Angel Flight or would like to get on board themselves, mm-hmm. What's the website where they should go for more information?
Angelflightwest.org.
And there are also links so you can hook up with the other Angel Flights mm-hmm. within, around the country if you're somewhere that is not serviced by the 13 states that Angel Flight
services. Yep, and it's also very easy to make a donation on the same website.
Thanks to Stuart, we're going to experience exactly what a passenger would on Angel Flight. Come along!